September until the beginning of November.
We wanted to see how the international companies and see what the employees cost and what their cost were, so.
So, Heco, the is a wholesaler, trader, and stuff is of stainless steel and aluminum product. The business name is Heco Levy, and Levy can be translated into English as a private limited liability company. The address is Almere, Boulder, Penn, and customers can contact this company by email or by phone.
Okay, so some basic information about the company. It was established in 1978, and they have this year they have 40 years. And the number of employees is approximately 30. This is the main building, and the working hours are from 8:15 until 16:45. And they have warehouses in Almere and in Antwerp, which makes it very efficient delivery.
So this was our working space, and this is the open air office where the account manager was standing, where or had a seat.
This is the entrance to the warehouse in Almere, and this is the inside. And as you can see, there are some stainless steel sheets.
So location, this company is located in Almere. That part of town is called Almere Outer. And on this picture, you can see the exact location in Europe. And it is located in the heart of the European Union, so it is really efficient delivery for them.
So, Heco has a lot of partners worldwide. The main ones are Germany, Turkey, Belgium, Italy, and the UK. It is not a surprise that Germany is the biggest and the most important partner, because Germany is the biggest manufacturer in Europe, and the second most important one is Turkey.
So, stainless steel products are really relevant these days. They are used from astronomy equipment to architecture. The most important advantages of stainless steel products are its sustainability, durability, flexibility, fire and heat resistance, and also really important is also an aesthetic appearance.
The Heco has a wide range of stainless steel products, as you can see, and it can guarantee quality as the products are 3.125, and they also offer second choice stainless steel products, which means that they can have small dents in them.
95% of all sold products represent stainless steel products. These products are mostly sheets and plates. Grade is AISI 304 and 430. This number is the name of the alloy of the stainless steel.
So this is the brochure of Heco. It's one of their promotional materials, and it helped us quite a lot when we first came to the company, because we didn't know anything about stainless steel, and this contains the basic information like as metal the
AISI
and finish, grain, and so on.
And also thickness.
So Heco has quite a lot of in-house services. One of them is polishing, which means that they brush the surface to make it shiny.
If a customer asks for a special protection, a polyethylene special protection surface foil can be added to all sheets and in place.
Then there is iconic, which means that from this bigger cloud they unwind it and they make it flat. And then they
so slipping, yeah, it means slipping those coils into smaller parts.
Then there's cutting, which means winding into the parts as the customer wants. And then there is leveling and laser and water jet cutting. And the leveling is not just a different material, and it's done to eliminate the tension in sheets and then into the product processing.
So in-house aluminium services are not very common, but they do usually coating, slitting, or decoiling. Outsource activities are not so important for them, but one of the outsource activities is really important when they don't have time to do it in-house, and that's cut-to-length service.
So this is the organizational structure of the company. As you can see, they have two directors, one is commercial and one is financial. We were under an account manager, Mr. Yannis Dispers, which has export in Eastern Europe and studies of the Scandinavian states.
So SWOT analysis is really important for a company. What I see as positive in this company is the effort of people. They really like their job and they are doing their best. Another strength are languages. There is the expertise of multilingual account managers who speak Dutch, English, German, Turkish, Russian, Spanish, and French. And location in the heart of the European Union is important too, and it is located near the capital in Holland, so it is beneficial.
So when we're looking for weaknesses, we couldn't find many, but one of them was capability. And when we were offering products to customers, we found that the customer wanted, for example, the sheets in a week, and the company couldn't make it for like 3 weeks. So the customer went to a different company instead.
So opportunities, I think the future is bright for this company. The economy is growing, so new firms are being established all around the European Union. So new potential customers are also arising. And when we are thinking about the world, they can enter new markets where they sell their products.
As Michael said, the new markets are good, but that also means that there is a competition. And competition is quite high in the European Union, and it's quite hard to become a leader, but it's not impossible. And then there is the language barrier, which languages are strength in this country as well, but in the European Union, each country has its own language, and it's quite hard to communicate when not everyone speaks English or Dutch or German.
So main suppliers are, for example, Autocomponents, that is one of the biggest stainless steel producers in Europe, and it's located in Finland. And the next one is, for example, Posto, that is a steel producer from Turkey.
And we have main customers of the company. For example, the rubber metal company. Our main task was to do the market research. When we first came into the company, we tried to find out the most about what it does, the services, and then came the market research. We contacted the customers, potential customers, and tried to offer them the products that produces.
So when we found companies where they can sell their product, we did them into an Excel chart. producing stainless steel doors, windows, railings, and gastronomy equipment, and stainless and aluminum producers who produce windows, doors, and also airplanes.
Once we found the potential customer, we sent down a commercial offer, as you can see here, and we tried to be flexible and send them in languages. We wrote in Czech, in Slovak, English, in Hungarian.
So once more offers were sent, we waited for a response. When we received one, we immediately translated it into English and sent it to our boss Yannis. And those customers were mostly asking for price list. So for example, here you can see an email from a Slovak manufacturer, and he was asking for a sheet with a thickness 0.8 millimeters, and we sent them the price list. For example, here, the price is more than 2 euros for 1 kilo of stainless steel. So, time for questions. Do you have any questions?
Yes.